you know, all the guys that run the different divisions at Trophy Quest, you know, usually sit behind the scenes or here at the office, you know, editing the shows, doing the marketing, you know, planning out different trips for clients to go to. But on this week's show, they get to go hunting.
Finally, John has let some of his staff members go hunting. We've been aggravating him about, you know, going on some of these trips, and finally we got to go on some. We got to go down to Bushmen Safaris in South Africa, and what a hunt it was.
Well, normally we're in the office behind the computer doing production or whatever, so it was really good to be actually out doing a hunt in the field. And
well, the first day at Bushmen Safaris, it was awesome. I bet we saw, you know, just for the first 4 hours of the morning, we saw maybe 15 different species, maybe over 100 animals at the waterhole. We had been in the blind maybe an hour, and these two shooter Gemsbok came in. They just kind of meandered around the waterhole, and we just kept waiting and waiting for the perfect shot. Okay, I knew I had drilled him, and he only went like maybe 150 yards, and I could see him go down, and I was stoked about it.
Well, here we are at South Africa, Bushmen Safaris. This is the first morning. There were two shooter Gemsbok that kept hanging around, and finally this one here presented me a shot, and luckily with the PSC, we got the job done.
Madison got his Gemsbok, so I gave him the camera, I got my bow ready, and it was my turn to hunt.
Kerry Brown, my director of marketing, has been working with Trophy Quest for about 6 months. We all wondered how he was going to enjoy this trip. This was his first hunt, his first bow kill.
What I was looking for was a zebra, and the reason I was looking for a zebra, if you're going to hunt in Africa, to me, a zebra kind of signifies that, and it was just the one thing I was really looking for and willing to wait on. So right after I shot, it looked like a great shot, but you know, it was my first shot, first ever. And so I was really nervous, really excited, hoping it was good. And we called the PH, and he came down there, and we went maybe 200 yards out and found it. So it was a good shot, everything worked out, but it was pretty nerve-wracking for the first time.
The first time hunting ever. In Africa at Bushmen Safaris, so it's been fun. I got a zebra my first time hunting, so that's pretty exciting.
Kerry, you don't sound very excited. In August, the man behind the camera.
Yeah, I've been with John for a little over 2 years now, and this really was a treat for me, being able to hunt and be in front of the camera and not behind it. It's been a pretty good day so far. We've seen waterbuck and bushbuck and warthog, and even some giraffes came in, so that was pretty neat. But I remember sitting there one time and I heard a commotion out to my left, and I look over there, and it looked like a whole stampede of wildebeest were coming into the waterhole, and that's when my heart really started beating.
Do you see that blood pouring out of him? Did you see that?
Boy, my heart was racing after I shot, and I watched the wildebeest run off, and he circled back around behind the blind, and I stuck my head out, and I looked over there, and I just happened to see him fall over dead. So I knew it was a great shot. The only thing left to do was to call Shannon and get him on the radio to come over there and help me load him up.
Good job, yeah, buddy.
Good job. On the same day I took my wildebeest, Madison was actually able to get one as well.
We had only been in the blind maybe 30 minutes, and two wildebeest came in, and one of them was a big mature bull. I was ready to give him an arrow. This hunt happened so fast. All I had time to do was just grab my PSC, and I drew back, and luckily I made a perfect shot.
So it's day six at Bushmen Safaris, about 8 o'clock. We just got to our blind, and hopefully it's gonna be a good day today. The weather's finally good, no rain, no clouds, and we've got about four different animals we're looking for: Impala, Blesbok, a warthog, a acre, and a steambuck. So we'll see what happens, and hopefully it's gonna be a good day.
About 30 Impala walked in with a nice old ram heading them all, herding them all. And so I was just waiting on him to get in a nice place where I could draw my bow, but he didn't want to stand still. So I've drawn my bow, I drew it probably 5 or 6 times when I thought I'd get a shot off. And as soon as I got back and ready to shoot, he would move. So finally, on like the 7th time, he finally stayed still long enough for me to shoot. He was about 30 yards, roughly. Longer than I wanted, but so we shot him and called the PH. They came over there. We saw which direction he went, so we headed over that way, and maybe 40 yards out we found him. So there's a good shot and good tracking. So we really didn't make it that far.
Well, after Kerry got his Impala, we headed back up to the blind. He picked up the camera. I picked up my PSE Omen. And wouldn't you know it, 5 minutes later, I look up, and there's a massive Kudu bull just standing right in front of me at the waterhole. You know, the edge of the water was about 35 yards, and I knew I had to make a great shot. It was a massive bull, and I'd only get one chance at him. Well, here it is, the PSE Omen. If you don't have one of these, you're just left behind. It's the fastest shooting bow on the market, and it didn't let me down when it came to taking that Kudu. Made a great shot on him as he ran off in the brush. I sat back down and started thinking everything over. You know, did I make a great shot? Did I do this? Did I do that? And that really, when your mind starts playing tricks on you, and 5 minutes can seem like hours. And I think every hunter can relate to what I'm saying. You know, as I walked up under the Kudu and I put my hands on him for the first time and just was looking at how awesome it was, you know, it really sank in that this was a trophy of a lifetime. And it just goes to show what kind of quality you can expect at Bushmen Safaris.
Madison, the head of TQ Adventures, you know, gets to go on a lot of these trips. He gets to go, but usually he's not hunting. He's checking out the destinations that we're wanting to send our clients. But on this one, it's a little bit different.
Bushmen Safaris, they take pride in their quality of game. And they told me that if any management Impala came in, for me to go ahead and take it. And wouldn't you know it, a one-horned Impala came in. I knew it made a good shot. That Ramcat went right through him. I could see him laying over there only maybe 75 yards.
We just had a management Impala come in. He was probably about a 17-inch Impala on one side, and he was broke off clean at his head there. So I can see him laying over there. He's only maybe 75 yards. This PSE Act 7, it sailed right through him. Never even stopped.
Luckily, I made a good shot on him, and that Ramcat, it sailed right through him. He only went like 75 yards, and there he was, laid up.
This one come in. We knew he was broke off clean at the skull cap there, and so we went ahead and took him out. An Impala this size they'll probably take this Impala back to the skinning shed, and they'll feed the whole staff at Bushmen Safaris.
Madison shot an Impala, and the truck drove away, and literally not even 5 minutes after the truck drove off, Blesbok walked in. Because it was so soon after the shot, I wasn't even ready with my bow when the Blesbok walked in, so I had to try to get my bow ready, get my release on. So he turned broadside and I took the shot.
Shot a Blesbok. It's my third animal here at Bushmen Safaris in South Africa. I think it was a good shot. Looked great. So hopefully he's sitting just on the other side of the water hole. We're going to go check him out in a second. So more to come. It's the seventh day at Bushmen Safaris. This is the third animal I've taken this week. This is a Blesbok. Used an X7 PSE bow with a Ramcat broadhead, and the arrow went straight through. It was clean, came out nice the other side.